Let's do this dirty laundry. Hey guys, it's Isaac. I'm one of the real queens of ATX. I'm a little hoarse right now because I was doing some protesting and I also got very sick. So yeah, there's that. So ordinarily, my topics that I would discuss during the week would be, I don't know, whatever I feel like it. I wouldn't have something prescribed. Sorry, that's my cat. He's really annoying sometimes. I want to talk about my experiences at the Capitol and with some of the pieces of legislation that people are talking about today regarding these quote-unquote abortion bills. So we find ourselves this evening in my natural habitat.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Riverside realness right there.
Obviously, topics like abortion can cause a lot of controversy. Let me be clear. I take this particular topic very seriously. I just want to say, I'm not for or against, let me start from the beginning. This isn't going very well. I want to be very clear when I say I respect whatever your opinion might be on this issue. For me, personally, I worry about accessibility for women, particularly in my hometown, El Paso, and women along the border. As a privileged gendered person, as a male body, it is not in my right to tell a woman what she can or cannot do with her body. I don't think anyone, Rick Perry, Senator Dewhurst, those awful, awful, awful men down there who were pulling some really nasty strings to make sure that the Republican vote would go in before midnight, it is not in their right to say that they know what is in the best interest of the women in Texas, because they don't. The most influential people in my life are women. My bestest friends in the whole world are women. The people I learn from most are women, born and raised here in Texas. If they're not given an opportunity to speak for themselves, then why does democracy exist? And when we stood there with the thousands of protesters who were there, I felt a lot of sorrow and disappointment from our state representatives who wouldn't listen to the thousands of voices that were telling them that this is wrong. And as I was hearing these women chant, "My body, my choice," over and over and over again, banging on the doors of the Senate gallery, I felt myself experiencing a part of history that was going to change things. And yes, Governor Perry called another special session, not even 24 hours after the filibuster ended, which we expected, but still. So now we wait. Again. And we persevere. And we fight. And we know sometimes we may not win. And that's okay, because someday we will find justice. Call me naive, call me stupid, I don't care. I have faith. One day, we will find justice.
The end result of this bill in a community like El Paso is that the nearest facility that a woman who was raped could go to would be in San Antonio. And I think is that acceptable to you?
In emergency rooms, they have what's called rape kits that the woman can get cleaned out.